Alrighty, here we are at round three, and everyone chooses to play last. Well, I would too, but not with this deck. We've got a fantastic hand. We got a bomb, we got removal, we got acceleration, we got the colors we need, kind of. Still need another forest, but other than that, I mean, can't complain too much. I'm going to have a turn three Trigon of Corruption. I mean, yeah, even if I am a bit stuck for forests, yeah, we've still got business. Although, seeing another forest by turn four, that would be fantastic. Alright, Mirsa. So, I could run out Rotwolf or Trigon of Corruption. That's tough. Because certainly Rotwolf is going to be good with Mirsa. Yeah, I think I want to run out Rotwolf first. I mean, I'm not super keen to be getting counters off onto the Mirsa. I mean, soon enough, but I mean, certainly there's going to be advantage holding on to Corruption until I have 6 mana, because then I can play and activate it in the same turn. Alrighty, and here we get to bash with the Wolf. Seems good either way. Seems even better if Mirsa blocks, so I hope it does. Any blocks? No blocks. Alrighty. Here seems a perfect spot to be dumping down Phyrexian Hydra. Next turn I'll be playing out Trigon of Corruption and then with Mana Up to activate it and go for the Throat. So, serious threats, serious removal. Good luck to my opponent to counter my start. Especially when I was on the play as well. I mean, it's a pretty brutal opening. Alright, Scrap Melt is going to take out my Plague Mirror. Aren't you glad I didn't play out Trigon of Corruption? I know I am. Alrighty. So, there could be grounds for using Go for the Throat on that Scrap Melter. I think I'd just rather... Well, if I Go for the Throat the Scrap Melter, that means I can bash with both my creatures. Then my opponent has the option... Well, I'd still get 2 poison damage in that way. Sure. I would like to get 2 poison damage in, thank you. Now that I have the option, certainly, again, once I get to 6 mana, I'll get more advantage out of Trigon of Corruption by playing and activating it in the same turn. I don't see this game going long, so I'm just going to use my Go for the Throat early, rather than worrying about what possibly could come out later, because I don't think it's going to be too relevant. Not with the rate that I'm killing my opponent. I can't see many runs of plays that are really going to shake up this board here very much. I mean, even Flensamite is fine, because... Ogre Resistor. So if I draw a land here, we're going to be looking good still. Alright, so there's the land. So I can run out Trigon of Corruption, so I can still bash with everything. Let's at least leave double black up, even though I'm going to be activating it. So, if I attack with everything, let's say Ogre Resistor blocks, Rotwolf, and it trades and I draw a card, and Phyrexian Hydra blocks Mir, and then I get in for 1 poison. If I leave Flensamite back, I don't see it being any different. If my opponent blocks Ogre Resistor on Flensamite, Mir on Flensamite, Ogre Resistor on Phyrexian Hydra, and then takes 2 more poison counters and I lose Flensamite, but I keep Rotwolf. I think either way, I think it's better just to get in with everything here. Again, don't even need to worry about the long term here. I've got no cards in hand, but I'm killing so quickly that it just doesn't matter. So I'm clearing out my opponent's creatures, and I'm left with 2/2 infect guys and a Trigon of Corruption. So we're looking good. We're looking good. My opponent at 6 poison. Certainly I could get stuck for lands here. get land flooded, I mean. Alright, Bone Horde. Making a sizable creature. I've got plenty of artifact removal, so if I draw removal next turn, I should be able to just clear it out. So, otherwise, I can put a counter on it this turn, put a counter on it next turn, makes it a 3-3. Now I'm gonna put another charge counter on. I'm not gonna play silly buggers putting poison counters on it. I'm just not too worried at this stage. All right, playing out another poison guy here. I could swing in with both, put my opponent to 8 poison, and still have 2 creatures. It's probably gonna be Phyrexian Hydra and Blight Widow. I think I'd rather just hold back and wait for... wait for artifact removal, because I do have several artifact removal spells. And if I can just clear out Bone Horde, then I don't have to worry about making bad trades. Alright, Horde Smelter Dragon. He's a beating. We're going to start shrinking him up. Okay, so Horde Smelter Dragon. In one sense, he's scary. In the other sense, well, he's... I'm going to put 2 counters on him. And then he can bash me for a little bit, but then I can... Ooh, that mother. Jeez. Then I can bash back for lethal. Alright, so I'm just going to play out that mother here. So Horde Smelter Dragon's going to kill my Trigon of Corruption. Should I just bash with everything here? No, not yet. I mean, I'd lose 2 creatures. That doesn't seem like value. I'll just hold out till next turn. So Horde Smelter gets a little bit of value by destroying Trigon, but then I just bash for lethal because my opponent only has 2 blockers then. So... Alright, Sphere of the Suns, that doesn't concern me in the slightest. Does my opponent just not have any more creatures? Because that'd be the only reason I could justify seeing a Sphere of Suns here. Because I only need to get 4, which means 2 creatures go unblocked. And I put a counter on Horde Smelter. And see what I draw for my turn. And bash with everything. What have I got to lose? Not a whole lot. Infiltration Lens to boot. Well, may as well. Let's see. I guess I don't want to put Infiltration Lens on that mother, because if my opponent's got instant speed removal, I guess I'll just put it on Rotwolf. I don't think it really matters. It's pretty... The Infiltration Lens is pretty irrelevant at this stage. So... I mean, even if my opponent blocks 2, kills 1... I don't see how that leaves him alive. If he can block 2, kill 1... then certainly... Okay, so if he's got a removal spell, then I should still be fine. I think I want to kill off Horde Smelter Dragon rather than the Bone Horde. So I'm going to remove... or I can remove a counter later. I guess, does my opponent want to kill artifacts in response? It's going to go for killing Trigon of... Oh, really? Instill Infection? Interesting. Leaving him at 1. Wow, that's exciting. So I guess I still want to kill Horde Smelter. Oh, I can either leave Vat Mother alive, or I can kill Horde Smelter. I think I'd rather leave Vat Mother alive, actually. Now that I've seen what the trick is, I'll leave Vat Mother alive. Horde Smelter will go to a 1-1, and he can start destroying my Trigon and my Infiltration Lens, which I really don't care about. And, yeah, my opponent can Bone Horde up the Horde Smelter, that's fine. And then I bash for lethal next turn. We're looking good. So my opponent was this close to dying. Had the trick that let him stay alive to see another draw step. But I can't see it going on for another turn. I should just kill next attack. And I can kill the Horde Smelter Dragon unless he equips. So it's going to be equip and play a creature, which means that Blight Widow goes on block. No, he's 9 poison. Needs to have 3 blockers, or a kill spell and 2 blockers. He's only got 2 cards. There's no way. It's not happening. Don't know what my opponent's looking at in his hand. I mean, he could have Cerebral Eruption, which could, you know, nearly wrath me, but other than that, he would have just had a crack with Cerebral Eruption. Kadol the Flame Fiend would clear out one of my creatures. Go dudes with big buds. Alright, so that's the end of that one. Red, black, huh? I could possibly take out Digester because it's underwhelming and bring in Withstand Death, seeing as how I haven't seen, Infect guys. That's about all. Not terribly enthusiastic about bringing in a Swamp Walker or anything. Mountain Walker. Yeah, even if there are ping effects, we were doing fine last game. Well, I guess I could take out Flensomite. Could take out Flensomite and put in, I don't know. Certainly we were doing fine last time. Let's just keep it as it is. Yeah, I didn't see anything that I necessarily need to take stuff out for. I mean, I could predict that there might be Blister Stick Shamans or whatnot, but, yeah, I've certainly got plenty of one-powered dudes that I can't really play around that so much. We're just going to stick on with what we got.